Hello. As you know, every object, animal, or human being on Earth is subject to a force called gravity. Due to this, if it's thrown in the air, this same object, animal, or human being will inevitably be brought back down to Earth. So to prevent this drop from being too brutal, man invented the parachute. The parachute is comprised of a canopy, which, due to air friction, creates what's called drag, and thus slows downward vertical movement, as long as the thing opens. Indeed, if you consider that a human without a parachute would fall at almost 200 kilometers an hour, with one, this speed is reduced to 20 kilometers an hour. But before getting into the details, let's go back in time.
While the principle of the parachute was imagined by Leonardo da Vinci as early as 1485, it wasn't until almost three centuries later, at the same time as the Montgolfier brothers invented the aerostat, that the invention of the parachute came about. 1 year later, after successfully landing after jumping from an upper story holding two parasols, French physicist Louis-Sébastien Lenormand made another design and called it a parachute, literally meaning to protect from the fall. But the first real jump was in 1797 by André-Jacques Garnerin, who thus became the first parachutist. With the advent of aviation a century later, the parachute drew interest from various air forces. And it was used during World War I to evacuate planes and airships in distress. But it was in the 1930s, with the creation of the first para-regiments, that the parachute underwent its real development.
Well, a parachute is generally composed of a harness pack inside which are two canopies. The main canopy and the reserve canopy, whose use is very rare, but whose presence is more than reassuring. While on some parachute models, the reserve canopy can open automatically in the case, for example, of a parachutist passing out, the main canopy is generally opened by pulling the ripcord at the front of the harness pack. Made of synthetic fabrics like polyamide and polyester, to make them extremely light and easy to handle, today's parachutes are still largely made by hand and rely on precious know-how. Their manufacture must meet very strict specifications, and 20 hours of work may be required for a small chute, and up to 100 for high-performance tactical parachutes. So-called individual parachutes are divided into two categories. On one side, those with a round canopy, designed for mass jumps by airborne troops. Their wide amplitude allows soldiers to be dropped at low altitude, with a load of 180 kilos. These parachutes made history when they were used by American paratroopers during the Normandy landings in 1944. On the other side, wing-type parachutes which, with their rectangular canopies, can glide and be guided like a paraglider. Enabling long-distance jumps, they're particularly effective for tactical missions as they allow troops to make stealthy incursions into an enemy camp up to 50 kilometers away. Reliable, high-performance, and easy to use, these parachutes are also used for sport. But today, there exists a whole host of other types of parachutes whose shapes and characteristics correspond to a variety of specific uses. For example, did you know that parachutes used for air delivery can drop loads of up to 20 tons from various military transport aircraft? Evacuation and braking parachutes, the first of which are used to save crewmen and equipment, notably their ejection seats, while braking parachutes are used to slow down fighter jets on landing. Munitions parachutes act as decelerators for dropping, as their name suggests, munitions. Finally, since the mid-20th century, high-tech parachutes called spatial parachutes have accompanied explorers in the conquest of space. They allow spacecraft, like this capsule, for example, to re-enter the atmosphere, descend, and land in all safety. For these so-called critical phases, the parachutes must be able to resist extreme temperatures and vibrations while providing as little weight and bulk as possible. But others are even used in space itself, A technological feat, because on Mars, the only planet accessible to us today, there's only a fine layer of atmosphere. But thanks to this parachute, designed by teams at Safran in 2012, the rover Curiosity was able to land on the red planet, followed by the NASA InSight probe in 2018. In short, since being invented, the parachute has consistently accompanied man in his craziest schemes, and its success isn't about to fall. So now you know everything, or almost. But before we go, know that parachuting is no longer considered an extreme sport for daredevils. In fact, especially thanks to accompanied jumps, it has become accessible and practiced by all kinds of people. So, fancy a jump?
Oh,